At Carrick on Shannon, 1845, the landlords of Leitrim in droves did arrive. They all to a man were invited to go to the Cora Drum Roosk agricultural show. The streets were bedecked with farm produce galore, and fashions the likes of which weren't seen before. There were traders from Sligo displaying their wares. A band from Drum Snap played enlivening airs. When the show it had ended, the gentry repaired to Church's Hotel, where a menu was served of pedigree beef, fine lamb and fish. They feasted on every conceivable dish. The head of the table, Lord Leitrim, stood up and said, "Gentlemen, let us now drain a cup to our Lord Lieutenant Victoria, our Queen, the finest monarch that Ireland has seen." A farmer from Mohill rose from his chair and begged the indulgence of everyone there. "It falls upon me, sir, I regret to say, to temper with caution this glorious day. There's news of a curse that is borne on the breeze, a newly discovered potato disease. There are tubers in Flanders black in the ground, but there are other sources of food can be found. I fear that this blackness is coming our way. Alternative sustenance without delay must be found if our tenants are going to survive, for it's on the potato alone that they thrive." Lord Leitrim laughed and put down his beer, regarded the good farmer Smith with a sneer. "This talk of blight and of shortage of food doesn't do my appetite any good. So, Farmer Smith, we beseech you and pray, do not sully and darken this wonderful day with your message of doom, your pessimist frown. We demand, sir, at once you desist and sit down. For potatoes are plentiful and disease-free, and potatoes are perfect nutritionally to feed all our peasants and keep them content, to pay us our somewhat exorbitant rent." Shannon, 2005, the town had expanded and businesses thrived. We were the landlords, a new king was crowned, a tiger whose unrestrained greed knew no bounds. A few brave dissenters said, "People, take care, there's a blight on our finances. Please be aware that it's all built on nothing. Why such demand for houses of clay on foundations of sand?" Our valiant leader rose up and said, "Begrudgers like you would be better off dead. We'll be the first boom to never go bust. No reason to change, there's no need to adjust. For Captain Fitzpatrick and Corporal Drum will march all our destinies into the sun. And loose regulation will set our boys free to do what they like to our economy." Languishing here in my ghostly estate, the tiger is gone, now the wolf's at the gate. The ghost of that farmer from Black 45 still haunts the highways with told you so cries. Still they won't listen, they don't want to hear that the good times will end, that the swill disappears, and all the pig troughing's no more in the offing till it's too late. Now Lord Leitrim is gone and his tenants are free. There's a Nama hotel where his home used to be, and a new type of landlord lays claim to our land, speaking a language I don't understand. I don't understand. Don't understand.